डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
वेलकम टू डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम डॉक्टर प्रतिभा सर, वेलकम यू इन द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मास्टर ऑफ साइंस इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी प्रोग्राम फॉर द सब्जेक्ट 103 इंटरनेट एंड वेब डिज़ाइनिंग। आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग दिस लेक्चर फ्रॉम द चैतन्य स्टूडियो एट द बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। इन द अर्लियर सेशन वी हैड डिस्कस अबाउट द वॉट इज इंटरनेट, what are the advantages and disadvantages of the internet. As we know that each and every technology comes with its own advantages, and its if it is not properly used, it has its disadvantages also. We also have discussed about the fundamental of intranet and extranet. Apart from this, we also have seen the difference between the internet, intranet and extranet, in which case we have to use the intranet and we should be using the extranet. We also have discussed about the internet access technology, right? How we can access the internet. We have discussed about the DSL, lease line connection, okay, and many other VSAT connections also. And each and every internet access technology has its own significance, and according to the requirement we can use this technology to access the internet. And we also had discussed the network topology, what is the physical how all the computers are connected, in which layout we have to follow, right? So sometime some organizations are following the bus topology, so other organizations are following the ring topology, star topology, and so on. In the previous lecture we had discussed about the bus topology and ring topology, right? So as we know that each and every network topology has its own significance. The network topology basically it explains the fundamental distributions of the computers and its connected devices, right? Basically it is the physical layout of the different devices like mobile phones, computers, laptops, and other peripherals also, right? So in the previous lecture we have seen the bus topology. There are many types of network topology: the bus topology, ring topology, star topology, mesh topology, tree topology, and hybrid topology. In bus topology we had discussed that all the devices are connected in a linear manner on a single shared line, right? So the communication is to be done only in a single direction, right? So if someone want to transmit the message to another person, right, it has this message is broadcast to broadcast to each and every locations. It is yes. Now if somebody is having that message, but it is not meant for that person, only the person for which the message it has been intended, it is to be delivered, it is to be responded by the receivers to the sender, right? And we also have seen where the bus topology is used. It is used in the Ethernet LAN. Now we have seen the advantages and disadvantages of the bus topology. It is very easier to understand and construct. It is less expensive. It requires very less connecting cables, right? Only single cable is required, right? So no much expense is required. Again, to maintaining such kind of topology is very easier, right? So anybody who is having the fundamental knowledge of the networking, he can be able to manage this bus topology, right? Again, each and every network topology has its own disadvantages, right? So as per the requirement of the organization, we have to use the respective network topology. Yes, what is the disadvantage? That is the length limitation, right? So you can have such kind of topology for very small distance, right, where the devices are connected in very small distances, you can use. But for the larger distances, you cannot use this bus topology, right? Then it is a slow speed. The transmission speed is very slow as compared to other topology, right? As well as it is less reliable, because if the single cable is failed, entire topology, entire network will be failed, right? So it is the network will be unused. We also have discussed the ring topology, in which all the devices are connected in circular manner, right? You can see here in this figure, the each and every computer is connected with two different computers, right, in a circular fashion. Okay, so the first device is connected to the two computers, again second device is also connected to the two computers, and so on, right? At the end, the last device is connected to the first, right? So it makes the closed loop. It makes the closed loop. Okay, so that's why it is called ring topology. Now there are some characteristics of the ring topology, that is we know that each workstation is connected to two devices. It is predecessor device and the successor device, right? And in the ring topology, the repeaters are used to prevent the data loss, right? So sometime if the ring network has been failed, right, you can recover your the data which has been sent from the sender to the receiver, right? Again, in this case, the bit by bit transmission will be taken place, right? So the data will be converted into the form of packets, and finally all one by one packets will be transferred in sequential manner. Okay, it follows the single directional data transmission, either clockwise and or it follows the anti-clockwise directions. Okay, so as per the requirement of the organization, they can follow the both dual ring, right, in which both type of transmission will be taken place, right, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Why it is necessary? Because if any of the ring has been failed, right, we can recover, we can continue our communication through with the use of another ring, right? So sometime it may happen that if anti-clockwise ring has been failed, right, so even though our communication would be continued on the clockwise ring, right, so we can convert our this ring topology in dual mode, right? So it is called as a dual ring topology, right? So two directional data flow has been done into the ring topology, right? So now data transmission is smooth, as node containing the token can only transmit the data, right? As the data is transmission is very smooth, right, as compared to the bus topology. Now there are the advantages and disadvantages of this topology. It manages the high traffic network, right? So if the requests are coming from many sources, right, and even it will be able to handle these requests, right? Again, the cost of installation for constructing such kind of topology is reasonable, right? Apart from this, the expansion of the this topology is feasible, because we just need to connect two wires with in between two devices, and finally it can form it is a part of this topology, right? Again, it has a very low cost, because only very few cables are required in this case, right? So that's why this is much more easy and easy to construct, and again the cost wise it is very much cost effective, as compared to other topology. And one of the biggest advantages of this topology, it is it manages the high traffic over the network, right? Then as I told you, each and every technology has its own advantages and disadvantages. Same way, the ring topology is also having the disadvantages. The first one disadvantage, that is laborious troubleshooting, right? So it is very difficult to find out at which point the problem have been occurred, right? So because all the devices are connected with each other in a circular fashion, right? So we have to troubleshoot each and every devices from the beginning, right, until the problem has not been encountered, right? Then this ring topology will be suspended. Yes, the entire network will be failed if any of the devices and has been suspended, right? So if during the troubleshooting, if we are doing the entire activity of the troubleshooting will be suspended, because all these devices are connected in a circular fashion. So if any problem encountered at any devices, right, so the transmission and communications will be suspended in this case, right? Then networks get interrupted by malfunctioning of the single workstation. If any malfunctioning have been encountered at any place on any of the devices on this topology, entire network will be get disturbed, right? And it is very difficult to again lead into the previous state, right? Then in this case, if any of the single cable have been failed, the entire network will be failed in this case, right? Yes, the transmission speed is also very slow, because when somebody want to send the message from source to destination, right, it has to traverse through the subsequent nodes, right? And unnecessary, the packets will be transferred to the subsequent nodes, right? So extra time is required to forward this packet to the final destination, right? And the speed of data transmission is average here, right? Now what is star topology? The third one is the star topology, in which all the devices are connected with the central device. It is called as a hub, right? Okay, so it makes the structure like a star, right? Only the central devices which handles the transmission between the devices, right? So there is a whole and sole responsibility of the hub, which forwards the message to the destination, right? So if some if the request is coming from the any machine, right, it has to be passed through the hub, right? And hub will transmit that message to the destination by looking after the IP address for which that message is intended, right? So overall, the management of transmitting will be done by the central workstation, and we call it as a hub, right? The data in this case, data transmission either can be done through the use of hub and repeater or switches, right? This star topology is to be used in a twisted pair, optical fiber or coaxial cable, right? To construct such kind of star topology, right, twisted pair, optical fiber and coaxial cable will be used, right? And these to purchase such kind of cables are cost very costly, right? Now as we have seen the advantages and disadvantages of bus topology and ring topology, right? So this topology, star topology itself, has its own advantages and disadvantages, right? Low network traffic among the few nodes, and it enhances the network performance. So this type of star topology is basically enhances the network performance, right, due to the low network traffic, right? So it does not have to pass through each and every subsequent nodes, as we have seen in the start ring topology and the bus topology, right? So the message will be directly sent to the receiver, right, from the source to destination, right? So low network traffic will be there, right? While in the case of bus and ring topology, when any sender want to send the message to the receiver, right, it has to pass through each and every nodes unnecessarily, right? So it generates the traffic over different nodes, right? No network downtime due to the malfunctioning of the individual nodes of the cable, right? So in case of if any of the cable have been occurred the problem, right? So while remaining nodes will continue their communication, right? In case of if this device is, suppose the in this case if one device is having the trouble, right? So only the communication will be affected to that devices only, right? While the remaining devices will continue their work, right? Okay. Then quick and effective troubleshooting. It is very easier to find out at which location the problem has encountered, and we can troubleshoot that device. It is effortless setup and transform, right? Until unless if you don't know at which devices the malfunctioning have been occurred, it is very difficult to find to do the troubleshooting. But here in this case, the troubleshooting is easily done, because just need to know where the problem have been occurred, right? So we don't need to scan each and every devices, right? The single workstation is affected by the dropout, while the remaining nodes works efficiently, right? So in any of the case, if the problem is occurred on any of the workstation, right? So that workstation is only affected, right? While the remaining workstation or devices will continue their work, right? So entire topology will not be disturbed here in this case. Then these all are the advantages of the star topology. Basically, there are some disadvantages of this star topology also. It is having the expensive installation, because so much wire is required. Each and every device needs to be connected with the central workstation, right? So suppose in our organization we want to would like to construct the star topology for 50 workstations. So how many wires or cables we would be required to connect with the central workstation? That is 50, right? Each and every 50 workstation needs to be get connected with the central workstation, and it has some kind of expense. It is some kind of expensive, right? Then expensive usage inclusive of devices. Yes, because we need to purchase the hub, and hub of configuration is not similar for each and every workstation. So we have to we require the hub, central hub, which can coordinate each and every types of devices, right? We should require the standard configuration of the hub, right? And to purchase such kind of hub is also very much costly, right? Excellent, it provides excellent speed during the transmission of the data, right? But sometime if the central workstation is busy in doing some another work at the same time, there is request is coming, right? It can the sender have to wait for some period of time, right? Because the central workstation can handle limited number of requests which are simultaneously coming, and at the same time if more than one request, so many requests are coming at the same time, right? The central server can be able to handle only one request simultaneously, right? So there is a traffic jam over the central workstation. The entire network downtime during the central connecting devices failure. Yes, in this case if the central devices have been failed, entire network goes down, right? So nobody will be able to communicate with anyone, right? The failure of connecting devices such as hub and switch leads to the drop out of the entire transmission. As I told you, if there is a problem or hardware or software problem have been occurred at the central side, right, or hub or switches, right, so the entire transmission will be broken. Okay, the star topology utilizes more cable in comparison to the bus topology. As I told you that each and every workstation needs to be connected with the central workstation, right? So if we have 50 workstations in the organization, each and every 50 workstation needs to be connected. So 50 wires or cables should be required to get connected with the hub, right? Reliability is hazardous as the failure on the headquarters stops all transmission. So if you think in a banking structure, if this banking structure have been structured like a star topology and there is only one server, so if this server has been failed, in that case the entire banking transaction processing will be failed, right? Nobody will be able to do anything, right? Neither they can view the statement, right? So nobody will be able to do the banking activities. Okay, so this is all about the star topology. Now what is mesh topology? The fourth one, it is called as a mesh topology. Basically such kind of topology is used in wide area network, right? If there is a very wide area, right, if you would like to build a topology for the particular organization, yes, in that case you can work with the bus topology or ring topology. But if you would like to expand the network, right, so in that case one should construct the mesh topology, right? Now in this case the connections devices are connected with each other, right, and according to the connectivity of the devices it has been categorize the mesh topology in two part. The first one, that is the partial mesh topology, and the second one is the full mesh topology, right? In case of partial mesh topology, not every devices or not only every workstation is not connected with every other workstation. Where there is a necessity of two devices, the communication should be taken place, right? That two devices needs to be get connected, right? While in some of the devices there is no much communication, so we don't need to consider the direct connectivity between them, right? So that's why it is called as a partial mesh topology. In partial mesh topology, the connection between two devices are not compulsorily done, right? Which of the devices are having the so much communication, direct communication should be done between them, right? So only the line should be constructed between these two devices. Then full mesh topology, right? In this kind of topology, all the nodes are connected with each and every one. All the nodes are connected, right? This is called, that's why it is called as a full mesh topology. All devices are connected with each and every other, right? So in this case you can see in the figure below, you can see each and every device is connected with each and every other, right? You can see the connecting line from one device to every other workstation devices, right? So that's why it is called as a full mesh topology. Now due to the significance of mesh topology, the fundamental of routing have been occurred, introduced, right? So what is routing? Internally such kind of topology, the routing table has been maintained, right, which contains the information about the multiple routes. Because if some devices want to send the message to another devices, the message can be passed through multiple path, right? Because multiple paths are available, and this top in this topology, the routing table contains the information about the shortest path, and the data will be transferred in that route only, right? Then the flooding, right? So here, in case of flooding, yes, when no nothing, this routing is not mentioned, right? Only those want to send the message, it will broadcast the message to each and everyone, right? So the flooding concept comes into the picture in this case. Now there are the advantages and disadvantages of this mesh topology. High fault tolerance due to the node to node connectivity, right? It is able to handle each and every request, right? Then speedy diagnosis of troubleshooting and fault. It is very easy to find out the faults, right? Then security in privacy is maintained because there is direct connectivity between two devices, right? In full mesh topology, right? Then data load is carried out by all connections, right? Okay. Then disadvantages of mesh topology is that complex installation and configuration. It is very difficult to configure because so many wires and direct connectivity is required in this case, right? Expensive in terms of connecting cable, because if you would like to construct the full mesh topology, it is very difficult to construct, and it requires so much cables, right? So purchasing of this cable is very much costly, right? Again, it requires a voluminous cable, right? So we do require such kind of cable who can handle, who can construct such kind of mesh, full mesh topology, right? Used in highly critical network due to the high cost, right? In some of cases, if such kind of network is very much complex, in that case we have to use the mesh topology. Now the fifth one, that is the tree topology, right? In such kind of topology, all the devices are connected with each other in the form of tree hierarchical manner, in which there is a root node, right? As we know that the tree structure, there is a root node. This root node has a child node, and this child node, it also has a sub child node, right? So the such kind of hierarchical structure, we have to maintain the connectivity between the devices, right? So you can construct the three levels of hierarchy in case of tree topology. In some cases where the group of workstations are needs to be maintained in one group. For example, there is an education institute. We do require one network for the academic and another network for the non-academic. And even though this non-academic and academic, they are part of the institution. So then these two different networks are connected to the common network, that is called as a root, right? So in that case, we can construct the tree topology. Now, as you can see in this figure, these two stars, that means these are the siblings, and these two stars are connected with the bus, right? So it forms kind of structure. This bus is called as a root, and the remaining siblings or branches are called as star topologies are called as a child, right? Now this tree topology has its own advantages and disadvantages, right? Yes, tree shaped simply distinguishable, right? So if you would like to communicate, non-teaching staff want to communicate with the teaching staff, right? So the message will be coming from the non-teaching network, and it will be directed to the teaching network, right? It is the extension of bus and star. So it combines two topology, bus and star topology. It is easy to expand. Yes, sometime if you would like to introduce new department in the university, right? Definitely one tree has been sub network have been needs to be constructed, and it is to be placed into this existing network, right? The maintenance and management is straightforward, right? Once where the problem has been encountered in which of the network, whether the problem is encountered at the teaching side, non-teaching side, or any other admin side, right? Only that portion is to be consideration into the mind, right? Speedy fault finding and troubleshooting, right? Then heavily wired, because so many these two star topology and bus topologies are constructed together, and finally it will become a tree topology, right? So many wires are required, right? Again, it is expensive, as because the purchasing of wires and cable leads to the cost, right? Expansion of nodes. Challenge is the maintenance, right? If you would like to expand this network, right, there are some kind of challenges occurs, right? Failure of connecting device leads to the network failure. As again, in this tree topology, if the root node has been failed, right, so there will be the disconnectivity between the two sub network, right? The next one is the hybrid topology, in which more than two different kinds of topologies are used. That's why it is called as a hybrid topology, right? In this diagram, you can see one network is having the star network, the second one is the ring network, and the third one is the bus network, right? So all these are connected together, and finally it becomes a hybrid, right? So each and every ring, star, and bus has its own advantages and disadvantages, right? So again, in this case, you will be getting the advantages of each and every technology and disadvantages also, right? Okay, then advantages and disadvantages, as I told you, whatever this structure having, which kind of network, right? If it is having star network or ring network or bus network, right, that advantages will be encountered here, right? Speedy troubleshooting, reliable fault finding, yes. Then effective transmission, right? Transmissions is effective. We can easily expand this network. It is highly scalable and it is flexible, right? So sometimes if you would like to remove any of the network from this hybrid topology, yes, we can definitely remove easily, right? Again, such kind of topology has a very complex design, right? It is combination of different topologies, right? Hierarchical mode of network, right? It contains three kind of structures of the network. Again, it is more expensive, right? See you in the next lecture. Thank you.